An emotional scene as frantic parents pacing outside the Robb Elementary School awaiting word if their child survived the latest mass shooting to hit the U.S. Around noon on Tuesday, the shooter, now known as 18-year-old Salvador Ramos, barged into the Robb Elementary School in the small town of Uvalde, Texas, and opened fire on innocent children and teachers. The gunman took the lives of 19 children and 2 adults before getting shot and killed himself, presumably by law enforcement that came to the scene. Authorities report that Ramos, a high school student in Uvalde, also likely shot and killed his own grandmother before heading to the school. They found an AR-15 rifle with numerous magazines and said he was wearing tactical body armor gear. Uvalde is just an hour away from one of Texas's largest metropolises, San Antonio, whose mayor, Ron Nirenberg, is of Filipino descent. Mayor Nirenberg tweeted his disgust on the sickening attack and sent his support team to their neighboring town. At the White House, fresh from his trip to Asia, an emotional President Joe Biden appealed to lawmakers to turn this pain into action.
As a nation, we have to ask, when in God's name are we going to stand up to the gun lobby? When in God's name we do what we all know in our gut needs to be done? Why are we willing to live with this carnage? Why do we keep letting this happen? Where in God's name is our backbone to have the courage to deal with it and stand up to the lobbies? It's time to turn this pain into action for every parent, for every citizen in this country. We have to make it clear to every elected official in this country, it's time to act.
Other prominent Democrats also speaking up on the need for stricter gun control measures in the U.S. Former U.S. President Barack Obama said, while they are grieving with the families in Uvalde, they are also angry for them. He added the U.S. has been paralyzed, not by fear, but by a gun lobby and a political party that refuses to act to prevent such incidents. U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris saying enough is enough, and it's long past time for the country to pass reasonable gun safety laws. This is the worst mass shooting in the U.S. since the 2012 Sandy Hook massacre that also saw 20 young elementary school kids dead along with 6 staff members. So far, no Filipinos have been reported to be any of the victims. Authorities have yet to determine a motive for Ramos's rampage, and they have launched an intensive investigation into his history and social media activity and influences to better understand what could drive a young man to take the lives of members of his own small community in the hopes that they can avoid these horrific events from happening again. TJ Manotok, ABS-CBN News, San Francisco, California.